Hello and welcome back to the channel, fellas. I want to take you on a flight today, a very special flight and one of my favorite ones as well. Most likely one of the flights I did the most is from Zurich to Milano Malpensa. Not as many as Sao Paulo or Los Angeles flights, but be assured I've done this route a few hundred times. Usually a cool 30-ish minutes of flying over the Swiss Alps, low flight level, and when excellent conditions occur, like on the day when I took this video, then it's well worth to have a closer look down. So today we are looking at some of the mountains, villages and points of interest on this route south towards Milano. We're on board of our A220-300, formerly known as C-Series CS-300, and we just took off from runway 28 at Zurich. Perfect weather for this Alp crossing today. We start our crossing now from the cockpit perspective. To our left at the end of the lake, you can see the city of Flüelen, the river Reuss leading into the lake of Lucerne. This river origins from the Gotthard Massif that lies a bit further south. Usually I don't have the time to spot all the peaks and enjoy the view from a passenger's perspective, so I'm glad I can share this view of the Alps with you all tonight. We fly directly over the Brunistock and the Engelberger Rotstock. The world-famous mountain Titlis lies directly to your right-hand side. Cruising on flight level 170 towards Malpensa, we can now spot the Matterhorn and Mont Blanc in the distance, as the first officer points out. I always loved geography. I thought that being in aviation and all, it helps to know your way around and basically know where on the globe that you are and so on. But making this video here, even I learned a thing or two about our mountainous region south of the main populated areas such as Zurich, Bern and Geneva. The actual crossing of the Alps on this route is done after less than 10 minutes of cruise. Only Wallis, the canton that is home to the famous Matterhorn, has over 41 mountains over 4,000 meters high. So here, Zuschtelplatz. In the valley to the left, you have Andermatt. There it is. Göschenen. Bit north of it, and the mountain behind Andermatt, that's the Gotthard Massif, where the Alp crossing and the tunnel go. And to the right, the big long valley that you see there, that's Oberwallis, that's the beginning of the canton of Wallis up there. The Gomsertal, actually. There's the Passo San Gotardo with the famous Alp crossing. Mittagstock. Mürtelis Horn. And the Göschener Alpsee. Lochberg. And as the name will suggest, the Rhone Stock, because right behind it is the Rhone Glacier, the Rhone Glacier. There you see the village of Goms, and that valley is the Oberwallis. Matterhorn in the distance, Mont Blanc, and as mentioned, the Rhone Glacier down there, the Grimsel, Hochspitz, and don't forget to mention the full Kapos. Fantastic road to drive through. Pizzugalina. Now left turn back to our desired heading. Smoke the horn. Like I said, guys, what a beautiful day to fly. It's all awesome. And you guessed it, where the fog lies, that's where Milano Malpensa is located. Pizzo Rotondo, you have guessed it, it gets more and more Italian, so the Italian border can't be far. Last little right turn. Kleingrieshorn and the Grieshorn right next to it. And back on the flight path. Lake Dolia, which is already on Italian territory, so the ridge in front of us indicates the border, left-hand side being Switzerland, right-hand side being Italy. And we're gonna fly right over the border, and you can see on the map Malpensa lying ahead of us, and we're heading right towards it for a downwind approach. And as we have now reached the top of the descent, I want to thank you all for your continuous support and coming on this sightseeing tour across the Alps with me today. Malpensa is ahead of us, and we will do a downwind approach for a landing on runway 35 left. If you want to see this for yourself, choose a sunny, cloudless day, hop on swiss.com and book the Zurich to Milano or Zurich to Venice flight. It's a daily service operated with the brand new A220. Thank you all for watching. Enjoy some outtakes at the end of this video. Hit that subscribe button and hopefully see you on board or in the next video soon.